A court challenged yet another one to the president's health care law presented by West Virginia small business owner will go forward. A federal judge allowing the case to move ahead, which challenges the idea of imposing tax penalties under Obamacare to those who fail to buy health insurance. It's about the subsidies and the exchanges and where they're run.
So let's talk to the judge about it. Andrew Napolitano is a Fox News senior judicial analyst.
Good morning, guys.
Good morning, Judge. On the merits, tell us about this.
It's a little complicated, but here's the law boiled down. If you earn less than $45,000 a year, four times the national poverty level, then you are required to acquire, or your employer is required to give you, a bare bones health insurance policy. If you earn more than $45,000 a year, you are required to have, either from your employer or you purchase it yourself, a more luxurious policy. Now, here's the kicker. If you earn right around $45,000, but a little bit under it, and you get a tax credit, a subsidy to help you buy it, that, according to the IRS, adds the value of the tax credit to your income. You get taxed on the tax credit. That puts you in the higher bracket, so you have to buy the more expensive policy, or your employer has to provide the more expensive policy for you. There are over 7 million people in that category, which means an enormous expense for employers as a result of this IRS revenue ruling that the tax credit, the subsidy for you to purchase the policy, is taxable income to you. Did the Congress decree this? No. Is it in the statute? No. Where did this come from? The IRS decreed it. So this lawsuit does not seek money damages. It does not seek to invalidate the statute. It seeks to invalidate the IRS's interpretation of the statute so that the employers of these 7 million folks don't have to pay for the richer policy, or these 7 million folks themselves don't have to pay for the richer policy. That's where we stand. But this is one of a dozen additional lawsuits challenging the complexity of this statute, written in such an ambiguous way that Congress fostered these complexities by the manner in which it wrote the statute, and it gave the IRS the opening to write these rulings which do not logically proceed from the statute.
But the judge did not block the implementation of the health care law while this is being heard in court.
No, and the lawsuit doesn't seek the health care law to be blocked. The lawsuit seeks to have the IRS's interpretation of whether the credit is taxable income blocked, and the judge denied that because he said that's remediable by a ledger entry afterwards.
Do you know enough about it to say whether this is a good argument, the argument that's being made here against the IRS?
I can tell you that the IRS rarely loses at this stage.
It's tough.
And because the lawsuit was not dismissed, and because this is not a jury case, it's a judge trial just before the same judge that refused to throw it out, I think the IRS is going to lose.
Oh.
And I think the IRS is going to lose big time on this one. This will actually help a lot of poor people in the United States who are only obliged to buy that bare bones policy.
Be back under
45. Will help employers who employ people in that $45,000 a year range by not forcing them to purchase the more expensive policy for them, which, as much as I disagree with the statute, was Congress's intent.
Right.
The IRS is frustrating Congress's intent. Why? Because they might be able to glom a few more bucks out of it for their coffers, which is their job.
Yeah.
Can I ask you something about the IRS just while you're here? Because I know you'll get fired up and your hands will start waving at everything. We keep talking about young people. They're essentially being taxed in a hidden way by having to subsidize older Americans in these health exchanges, older and people who are ill.
Right. That's the statute. That's not the IRS's fault.
No, but the IRS will be charged with going after these people if they don't buy this health insurance. How aggressively do you think, if they don't buy this health insurance, how aggressively will the IRS go after them to pay these penalties?
Probably about as aggressively as it goes after everyone else, which is uber aggression on the scale of aggression. I mean, that's Congress's fault.
Okay.
Man, it is complicated, but you did. That was very good.
Thank you, Judge.
As always.
Great to see you.
Pleasure,
Judge Andrew Napolitano. See, I got him to point his finger a little bit.
A little bit.
Hey, baby! The week is not complete unless we see
get
that.
The judge